is this irresistible creature who has an insatiable love for the dead?
Something that's came across my head, I had a few questions, you know, about what is the best starter snake. Well, as I mentioned previously, I think the ball python is. Now, some people will sit here and give advice to people that the ball python or a Colombian boa or a boa constrictor. Well, I have different feelings about that, okay? Because look, when you're growing up, you're what, 10, 11 years old right now, or 12, getting into this hobby, you forget one thing. You are guys, okay? You're going to be getting into what they call puberty soon, and you're maturing. What that means is you're going to be scoping out the girls when you get around 14, 15, and 16, which I've noticed this about a lot of people. Okay, a lot of kids that's grown up, they'll have a pet snake when they're like 10, 9, 10 years old, but as soon as they reach a certain age, about seeing the girls, wanting to party, thinking about getting their license, always wanting to drive, well, they seem to forget about their snake. Then guess who? Guess who has to take care of it? We do. The parents. We got to take care of it. So I'm going to show you, parents, if you're watching. I'm sure your kids probably won't show you this, but hopefully they will. But I'm going to show you some snakes. And the reason why I say that the ball python, I think, to me, personally, is the best starter snake. They don't get very big. They get probably maybe around 4 foot. And that's the females. I mean, they don't get very big at all. They're manageable. And you as parents, you can take care of them. You know, if your kids decide to be doing other things, maybe it's not their fault, though. You know, I was young once, too. And I know all about running out chasing the girls and stuff like that. And I just want to show the parents what they can look forward to versus the ball python versus the boa. Okay, parents, when your kids are getting into the snakes, here's what you're going to see in the pet stores. You're going to see these little beauties. If you buy them from a pet store, like Petco, you're going to be spending about $89 for them. As you can see, you know, you can get cute, little teeny baby, and your kids are going to have a blast with them. There's no doubt. Okay? Like I said, they don't stay this teeny size forever, as y'all can see that. They just don't stay this size. They do grow. And I'll show you what they look like when they're about full grown. Okay, parents. Now this is your adult ball python. I mean, she's in shed right now, so she ain't all that pretty. But this is what you'd be dealing with when your kid is around puberty and around 15 years old or so. And if you got to take care of it, this is the only thing you have to take care of. As I said, they're very manageable. They're not very big, which is one of the reasons why ball pythons are so popular. But I just wanted to show you parents what they look like when they get about adult age. Let me get her back so she can shed. I hope some of this is educational now. Here comes the boas. Okay, parents. Well, here's your female boa, okay, which is just, you know, Colombian boa, which you can buy from pet shops. They run you about, say, about $150 to $170. Like if you go to Petco or something like that, you can find them cheaper, maybe through mom and pop, you know, kind of places. But other than that, you'd be spending that kind of money. Yeah, they are cute, ain't they? Kind of small. You're thinking to yourself, oh, that's manageable for my son. You know, he really wants to get into it. Yeah, very manageable. Easy to take care of. Fun to take care of. But I'll show you what you're going to be dealing with in the future when some of your young boys start turning into men and noticing girls, because believe me, like I said, us parents, where we taking the, you know, we take the brunt into things when kids fall out of the hobbies and whatnot. They get interested in girls and partying and driving cool cars. And like I said, this is your female boa constrictor. Like I said, they're not, at this age, yeah, very manageable. Even, I'm gonna tell you, even at the older ages of their lives and stuff, when they get real big, which they get around 8, 9 foot, 10 foot maybe, some can get up to 11, some boas can get up to 11 foot. I mean, they're still manageable. Like I said, I'm gonna show you the reason why I say ball pythons versus these are a lot better to have around for parents to have to take care of, just in case your kids do get in that partying stage. Alright, parents. Well, the female you just saw, that little baby, they turn into these. Big guys. They ain't small by a long shot. They get real nice and big. This is an adult. This is your Colombian boa. He's a male, so he didn't get much more bigger than this. Like I said, they're manageable. I just wanted to let y'all know that them little babies you see in the pet stores, this is what they grow up to be. I'll do videos on care sheets and tips, because I've seen a lot of people wanting to see that. But I thought tonight, while I'm cleaning cages and changing water, that I'd bring a couple of these out and let you see. Well, I hope you enjoyed this little presentation. And kids, no offense, but like I said, I was a boy once myself, and I know how it is when you get older. Well, let me put this one back before it decides to strangle me, because this is not a good way to hold one of these. Which is, I am screwing up. But one of these days, I guess I'll learn my lesson by doing that. But you never really want to do what I just did and let them get all the way around your neck. You always want to hold them out. If you can put them around your shoulder, at least keep their head out where you can at least be able to grab and pull them off. Because sometimes they do. They're not meaning to, you know, hurt you or anything. It's just they can wrap around your neck and give you a good squeeze. And if they're hungry, heck, I don't even want to find out. Because I felt this one many times around my neck, and believe me, I don't want to find out. Like I said, I hope y'all enjoyed. Thank you.